Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 7.3, Problem 12. This is Section 7.3, Problem number 12. It says, fill in the blank. The probability that negative 0.2 is less than or equal to z is less than or equal to negative 0.07 equals blank. So I like to start these with a graph. You don't have to. Basically, this is an in-between type of question. We're going to find two chart values, subtract them. That's going to be the answer, but I think it helps if you can see your opponent. So I'll set up a bell curve. So negative 0.2, so negative 0.25 is a quarter of the way between 0 and negative 1. So negative 0.2 is going to be not quite as far to the left as negative 0.25. Negative 0.2 and negative 0.07. So you can think of this as like negative 20 cents, negative 7 cents. You have a very, very thin band of area on your bell curve that we want to find the probability for. So what we have to do is look up both negative 0.2 and negative 0.07 in the chart, find the two chart values and subtract them. All in between questions like this one, that's the way they handled. So first, negative 0.2, look that up. Step one, write it so that it has two places after the decimal. So I'll write that negative 0.2 as negative 0.20. That way I have my two places after the decimal. The next step is I split that number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. The third step is I put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that I pulled off. And now what I do is I go to the chart, I go to the negative 0.2 row, which is down near the very bottom of the negative portion of the chart, and I look in the 0.00 column, that's the far left column, and see where they intersect. So negative 0.2, 0.00. And if you intersect that row with that column, it should be 0.4721. So that's my first chart value. So I repeat that process for negative 0.07. So first write that so that it has two places after the decimal. And it already does. That I don't have to do anything with. The next step is I split that number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So the 7 will come off to the side, so I have negative 0.0 and 7. The third step is I put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that I pulled off. Now, ironically, it looks almost the same, but this process tells you what row and what column you're going to look in. There is a reason for it. It looks like you're undoing it and redoing it, but you're really not. So I'm going to look in the negative 0.0 row. That's the very bottom row in the negative portion of the chart. And I'm going to follow that out until I'm under the 0.07 column and see where those intersect. Those intersect at 0.4207. So now I have my two chart values. Because this is an in-between question, I will subtract them. So, and you want to subtract in an order that gives you a positive result. The answer you're getting is a probability. Probability must be positive. You can never have a negative probability. So I will subtract 0.4721 minus 0.4207. So if you're doing this by hand, I'll borrow. It's going to be a 4, a 1, that'll be a 5, and a 0. 0.0514. So that's my answer. That's what fills in the blank. And based on my drawing, I expected a small area. It's such a narrow band, such a small amount of area. I expect a small probability. So the answer is a little bit more than 5% chance. So the probability that z is between negative 0.2 and negative 0.07 is a slight bit more than a 5% probability.